Hey everyone, I'm Shake from Fat Cab Motorsports. It's September 30th, and this is a video that's not about suspension truth so much as it's about my experience with health. And I'm putting this on my channel in a way because I have an audience here, and I think most of my audience are probably men, probably at least mid-20s, generally, not always. If you're younger, great, but generally mid to upper 20s to 60s and 70s, and you know, even older potentially. So to be able to really enjoy driving, to stay sharp, to be able to, you know, be comfortable behind the wheel, whether you're racing or just going for a back road drive, I mean, your well-being is important. It's vital. And I'm going to be turning 41 tomorrow. I say this form was born in 1974, and five years ago in 2010, my father passed, and that was a big turning point in my life. And in many ways, it was kind of a wake-up call for me, because I didn't understand, for example, what diabetes, really how diabetes started, and heart disease, and how they were correlated, and diet and lifestyle behaviors and choices that could lead to that. Because we have a lot of control over how well we're harmonized, you know, just in our own bodies. Because a lot of what I talk about is ride harmonizing, you know, you and your vehicle. And that's become now a very richly layered subject, because how you are harmonized within your own vehicle makes a big difference. I say it makes all the difference, right? If you're not feeling good, if your back hurts, if your legs hurt, your knee hurts, if your shoulders hurt, if you're not feeling vital, you wake up and you're dragging, you need coffee to get yourself going, you know, whatever the case is, you're not enjoying your life as well as you can. I've been really fortunate that for the bulk of my life, I've had good health in general. A few bouts here and there, a cold that can last a week, or a flu, whatever it is. But generally, I've stayed really healthy. And since starting FCM in 2006, officially, I was doing it since about 2003, 2004, but didn't really actually get a little shop set up and start doing that, even though it was my parents' garage at first for several years. And then for what, 5+ years now, it's been here at this, our small but, you know, our own shop location here in Redwood City. and I always love pushing myself. I'm meant to be sort of on the edge sometimes. my dear friend sometimes says, you even sleep on the edge of the bed. Sometimes I like to do that. But in the process of pushing the limits, you know, whether it's in whatever way, you've got to take care of yourself. You really, really, really have to. And so this video is really kind of an encouragement, a wake-up call. There's going to be a few different things I want to touch on. Several people I've met recently, there's one gentleman who came by, a friend of a friend, who complained about having a bad back. And he's probably in his mid-30s, if that. And I think he's a computer programmer, computer engineer. And so he's got a Miata, he wants to maybe do some improvements to it. He's wondering if the seats were bad or if the suspension needed work. He didn't even know that you could really make the suspension better. So, you know, there's a lot of people who don't know that I exist, and that not just I exist, but that you can make changes to your car, but not just changes, but improvements. Because the whole thing, it's not just changing something, it's making a change that's an improvement. Because who wants to change something and have it be the same or worse if you don't like it already, you know? So that guy was kind of, it brought up again to me the importance of a smooth ride and a harmonious ride that gives you this uplift. You know, you go down the road and the car's not jacking you down to hell, it's lifting you up to heaven, or at least keeping you stable and even. And that's going to keep your spine from overly compressing and your neck and your back. I mean, it's, I remember a very brief period of time about 3-4 years ago when I was testing out an R-package suspension on my 94R, and it, after about driving it for maybe 3-4 weeks, I started to notice some back pain, and I was like, what the heck is going on? I thought I was taking decent care of myself and everything, and then I realized, oh, the car is just freaking crazily stiffly down, just pulling me all the way down all the time. So, and you know, everything that we do 10, 20, 100,000, 10,000 million times, you get into millions of cycles of your suspension bouncing, any type of oscillations, movement, walking, if your shoes aren't good, if you have flat feet and haven't gotten checked for orthotics, or if you have foot problems, please go get checked for orthotics. Go see an orthopedist. There's a guy that I know, Dr. Hannaford here in, he's in the Northern California area. He's a podiatrist and sports podiatrist. I mean, he's a ultra marathon runner. He and his wife, Debbie, they go all over the place. They've been in the Himalayas and like probably what, 100K, what do they call them? Ultra marathons and whatnot. I mean, I won't do that. I just don't want to do that to my knees, but they have the right gear, the right genetics, then they take care of themselves. But anyway, I have orthotics now, and I hadn't had them for about 4 or 5 years or so. And it made such a huge difference to me just to be able to stand and work at the shop for, you know, 6, 7, 8 hours a day. And I'll break it into a couple sections. But I need to be able to be physically fit so I can do this work, because it is physical work. You have to stand. I don't want to sit all day long either. I mean, I'm sitting making this video. But a lot of you watching probably sit a lot of your day. just things that you can look at, like ergonomic chairs or chairs where you actually your knees kind of curve behind. So there's different ways to take care of yourself in that way. To stand up, to stretch your back, and to do yoga, to do bends. I mean, really, guys, girls, whoever's watching, and I'm really saying this to guys because, you know, we sometimes don't consider our health to be an important thing, and we love to have our hobbies, and a little bit of a beer belly is not a big deal, or a bigger one, it's not a big deal, but it get to a point where it is a big deal. And if you don't start nipping in the bud now, whatever your age is, then as you get older, if you haven't already noticed issues, it's going to get worse. It's more than likely going to get worse. Things only get better when we attend to how do we make things better. I really avoid gluten now. Like, I just can't tolerate it. I have it very, very occasionally as like a breadcrumb. If I have some cheesecake and there's some graham cracker crumb, I'll have that like once every 3 weeks or something. I would rather eat some potatoes. Mashed potatoes or whole potatoes or something like that, rather than like fried french fries. Like fried foods are not good for you. Your the damaging parts of your LDL cholesterol, low density lipoprotein cholesterol, will go up. I just had blood panels done for the first time in a long, long, long time. And so it was a motivator. I wanted to know, like, okay, where am I right now? I haven't had this done. I haven't seen my blood results other than getting cholesterol levels from when I was going to donate at Stanford Medical Center, the blood center. And I'm like, I wonder what's going on. And overall, I was in decent shape. I probably need to cut down some of the like juices that I put into just to smoothies or to when I go get juice. I do beet, carrot, kale, spinach. Sounds good, doesn't it? I don't know, broccoli, sometimes cucumber, celery really overwhelms it. So if you're not absolutely a huge fan of celery, I would rather just eat celery by itself and then have a juice. If you want to eat all your veggies, great. I talked to a guy in line, asked him if he get the juice. He's like, no, I just eat it whole. I'm like, okay, cool. If you really are eating enough, that's awesome. But if you're not, if you don't want to spend, half your day eating like that much vegetables, juicing is good, and also making sure you get your fiber, in whatever other ways. I throw in blackberries sometimes, or have them throw in blackberries. I used to do apple and pineapple, but I think that was starting to make me store more fat than I needed to. We're really meant to metabolize protein and fat. Obviously, I'm not a doctor. This is not medical advice. I'm giving you my experience and also what I've studied and what I've learned and what I've experienced myself. So, and if you have comments, please add your comments, questions, because this is, I hope to be, I want this just to stir other people, whether or not it's your birthday or you're, been thinking about health. But if we're not feeling good, we can't enjoy our hobbies. We can't get under the car and work on it. We're gonna have to hire somebody else, and we wish that we could maybe, but we just physically can't do it, or our back hurts if we're trying to go for a ride, or we're not chasing our kids around, you know, or having fun, or chasing our wives around the house, you know, and terrorizing them in whatever ways we do, and just being like a lively, vibrant adult man, you know, whatever sense you are. So man or women, but like I said, I'm really addressing guys right now. So, and because this is my experience, obviously, of life. So I've paid much more attention to also like really good quality grass-fed whey protein is a really, really excellent way to make sure you're getting sufficient protein. You don't have to get, you know, the fats around it. If you don't want as much of the fat, you can moderate that. Coconut oil is awesome for you. It helps to prevent Alzheimer's, I believe. There's some studies that have indicated this. It's also really good for your HDL. It's got antibacterial and antimicrobial and antiviral benefits. You can rinse with coconut oil in your mouth and spit it out, and it'll basically be like, it's called coconut pulling, I believe. There's also, obviously, olive oil is really well regarded. I think grass-fed butter, I love butter. I don't have a problem using it in most things, and in fact, I think it's probably moderating fats in general. You don't want to go overboard with it. I've been also studying about nutrition. I mean, guys, if you're not lifting weights, please start. Find a trainer, find somewhere to do it, get some advice, even pick up some dumbbells, and isolate your muscles, you know. Don't try to do too many things all at once. But I just keep some, I keep some dumbbells near my desk, and three, four times a week. And I'm going to get into a gym, but right now all I've been doing is I've been doing like, you know, an arm curl. Sometimes I'll do like a bent over row. I'll do like a combination. I mean, sometimes if you do actually a sequence of exercises where you start from like push-ups, you can get like those rotating things if you don't want to hurt your wrists. Those are really helpful. Like when you do a push-up, you start like this and then you go down, and that way it kind of, it rotates so you don't hurt your wrist. It's really, it's called a perfect push-up thing. I'll probably annotate it down below. I mean, you could take it with you when you're traveling, you know, so it fits into like a really small package size, stuff it into your carry-on. There's no reason why we need to allow ourselves to get overweight and decrepit, really, because we're living longer. We need to live vital. And I want my customers to be like the best fit, taken care of, so that you're already getting the benefit of suspension that's been lovingly tuned, so that I'm thinking about your body and your welfare and your mind, not getting jostled around inside a really crappy tuned suspension. Someone who's like, oh, it's sporty, it's stiff, it's fine. It's like, no, I know better now. I've been there, done that. I mean, I've been doing this for almost 20 years, like the suspend driving game. And I've been tuning for over 10 years. So I know what works, both speed-wise and comfort and taking care of you guys and gals, you know, all of you. So weights are really, really beneficial. There's supplementation. I would recommend looking into DHEA. There's a lot of studies that indicate that DHEA, which is also called the fountain of youth or the elixir of youth, has shown benefits. It seems to benefit both men and women in similar but different ways, depending on obviously your hormone profile, and with like no detriment to your like lipids, your blood counts, or other markers in terms of making your cardiovascular function any worse. It just seems to restore a measure of vitality and I think your body's ability to repair itself where you may not have had it before. There's hormonal replacement therapy, testosterone replacement therapy. There's a great doctor I just came across called, I think, Morgan Thaler, who's in Boston. And there was a video I came across, and he wrote a book called Testosterone for Life. And he's Harvard educated. He's controversial because he's recommending therapy where, you know, women get estrogen therapy, and there's some risks apparently between adding estrogen and progesterone together. DHEA has been shown to have benefits similar to estrogen and progesterone without the detrimental side effects that those two together can give you. I think the studies on women have mostly indicated that estrogen can be a benefit, and then they've added progesterone as well, but that could be a detriment. So I think they need to do, there's more studies that are either being done or planned to be done on simply estrogen therapy. And there's also like growth hormone. So I would definitely talk to an endocrinologist. Get your labs done, guys. Get your labs done. There's a good website that I've come across called dangerandplay.com. And I was inspired by the manager owner of the site, Mike Cernovich, who's in his late 30s. He started to do his labs, I think, over 10 years ago. He's connected with another guy. They're both into weightlifting and they're fit. And they do take testosterone. They do injections, from what I understand. And they've had their labs done and their markers done. So they have tracked themselves, and they've also, I believe, had, you know, worked with a primary care provider as well, you know, your family doctor, and seen an endocrinologist. And often, if you've done more reading on this, and, you know, doctors have sort of a love-hate relationship with people who, well, they can, who go online and, oh, I Googled this. Well, if you have studies that can back up what you're saying, which is why when I mentioned the DHEA, I was looking at a ton of studies last night. There were like 144 links in this one, you know, PubMed search field that I saw. And I was highlighting and, you know, adding to reading lists and taking, you know, screenshots of sections that were particularly useful, or abstracts and result summaries that were really useful. Because often doctors don't have the time to look at every single thing that we do. They're too busy seeing patients, and then they go to lunch if they're lucky, and then they go home, and then they have some time to relax and see their family, have their own life and hobbies, and they come back to work. My sister's an MD. I have great respect for doctors. I really know that there's a ton of education you guys have got to go through. At the same time, the studies are not something that you may be required to keep up on. You have to do your boards and whatever your certifications are. And I don't know what's involved, and if that means you have to stay up with modern or with current studies and findings. But I gotta believe that you just, like, I don't have time to read the news and follow all the things going on. I didn't even know about Dieselgate until somebody told me about it. You know, this is like over a week and a half later. So it's, as long as you can cite a source that's, say, a medically verified journal, whatever the case is, then if you have something that shows up in your labs or in your own symptoms, then you have labs that can benefit it. Because I came up with low testosterone, at least low total testosterone. My free testosterone was at the low end of the normal range. And I also had shingles last year. And I've been just driving myself like crazy for several years. And last year was a particularly intense year. And when I started to develop these symptoms of this, you know, really, really painful, sensitive blisters, which I thought were just zits on my chest, but they only showed up kind of in one band, and they started to get, then I'm like, oh, that's what this is, you know, herpes zoster, which, you know, called shingles. And I was 39 years old. 40, I guess, technically. People are like, oh, you usually get that in your 50s or 60s or something like that. I'm like, I guess I was ahead of schedule. I may have mentioned this in another video. I probably did. But that was another wake-up call for me. It's like, okay, I've been really taxing myself. I need to also look into a full thyroid panel. My good friend Jason, who actually is Jason C. SBB, if you're on Miata.net or Club Roadster or Miata Turbo, whatever, wherever else he's posting. I think Miata Turbo and Miata.net. I'm going to ask him if he's willing to do a video, whether it's just I record him over the phone, or we actually do like an interview face-to-face, or I just have him, you know, send me some comments so that his experience, because he's had to deal with like gluten sensitivity. His wife has had to deal with Hashimoto's disease, which has to do, I think, like extreme gluten and other grain sensitivities. So he's been monitoring his own blood work and has been moderating his diet and taking supplements and doing things like modified potato starch to help reduce your glucose, to improve your insulin sensitivity, to decrease your like fasting glucose levels. So there's a lot that can be done. And I'm not a fan of most over-the-counter or prescription medication drugs. If you look at side effects, God knows what you're getting. And if any of you guys or gals are prescription drug users, and if you're upset at me, then please add your comments below and tell me what you think, and let's have a conversation about it. A lot of what we end up suffering from are nutritional deficiencies. Dr. Joel Wallach is a really, really, I believe, a really excellent, trustworthy, experienced source who's studied both from, I mean, he was a, an animal veterinarian and studied deficiencies in, and did necropsies on animals to essentially be able to see what they died from. And he's worked with individuals now for decades as well to see what are the causes of different diseases and how can we mitigate them. So that's another link I'll make sure I put below. Longevity is the company he's in. I'm not a multi-level. I'm not into that. I'm not doing that program. But it, you know, if you dismiss something simply because, oh, someone's making money off of it, well, that's how the world goes around, people. I mean, I need to sell suspension so I can keep doing what I'm doing. And I need to be fit so I can keep building suspension so I can take care of you folks. So it's like this whole cycle of, you know, my dad always said, you know, you, if you don't have your health, you don't have anything. He said, you have to take care of your health first because nobody else will. Nobody else will care as much about your health as you will. If you're lucky, you have a partner that loves you enough to encourage you to do things. Sometimes you have to, even if you tell them, shut up, leave me alone, but, or you tell them and they say that to you, then you're like, no, I'm not leaving you alone because damn it, I care about you. You know, put the donut down, you know, one a week, whatever, not at night, whatever the case is. So, yeah, you know, you get around birthdays and usually we take stock of things, especially as you get a little bit older. I think when I was in my 30s when I first started enjoying the idea of having a solo birthday party or a solo birthday, at least a good part of the day. So that's what this video is about. And I'm at 21 minutes. I won't make any promises about how long it is, but I'm enjoying sharing this and I hope you're enjoying hearing it. Definitely we have the ability to make choices to improve our well-being and to have a greater quality of life. And what's an interesting thing you find in some studies is that, and the placebo effect is something people will dismiss. If you read a study and it says, oh, placebo was shown to be the same as this or not much better than this, your belief will affect your physiology. And that effect has gotten stronger and stronger over time. I think the placebo effect can account for over 40%, if not more, of results that the drug itself can. So before you dismiss something as, oh, the placebo showed as much of a benefit or almost the same benefit as the real thing, there are some very solid psychoenergetic science that demonstrates why that can be. Because your own intention, I mean, if you really convince yourself that taking a sugar pill was like the fountain of youth, you would get the benefits of whatever. At least you could program yourself to do that. And you can call it woo-woo. Woo-woo just means something that we don't understand fully. When something's really fully understood or well understood, then it's no longer woo-woo, it's science. It's a different dimension of science. And that's another subject for another day, maybe conversations over beer. But Dr. William Tiller, who I think I've mentioned before, is one of many researchers who have been looking at the effects of meditation and mind on physical reality, on being able to change your environment so that, you know, when you love what you do, when you love where you are, you love who you're with, especially when you walk into a space and you're where you work, where you play, where you live, when you're broadcasting your joy and your happiness and your gratitude, you are changing that space literally at a level that can be measured at a level of entropic effects, you know, disorder versus order. You are altering the thermodynamics of that space. And this has been measured and found in various places around the world. And it can happen in conference rooms when there's going to be a conference of some healing art. And when Dr. Tiller and his associates have gone in and measured like the pH of water in that room, and they can see it goes from a very disordered state to it can actually have these random fluctuations that are, as he calls them, very orderly and lawful. Like something is becoming structured and there's a sort of a support to this environment that's being created. Like when you walk into a church or synagogue or a mosque or, you know, any type of like a holy place or place that people have come to with their intention and their needs and desires, And you can feel this. You come into someone's home that feels really good versus a place that feels really tense and just you're like, I don't know what it is, but I can sense something. I mean, animals get this. You know, that's why we have animals as guard dogs and, you know, and guard cats. If you have, my sister has a guard cat because she's like crazy about defending the property. But animals get this. We get it when we aren't judging, where is this coming from? Is this real? Is this, you know, am I nuts or did I watch too many episodes of X-Files or something? So I really believe that, you know, our intention to create X, Y, Z in our lives is truly, truly vital. So I'm very grateful that I have this opportunity. I've been in this fat cat endeavor for, you know, over 10 years, I'm going to say. And there was a time that I was feeling, you know, like, I think I need to get out. And it's just, no, I want to stay in it. I am in this. This is my art and my passion and my craft, and it's informing the Smooth Ride campaign, which I'm very excited to see this be born also, this other child that I'm co-creating with a good friend, partner, wonderful, crazy collaborator. And that's an and. It's Fat Cat and this, you know, and me creating my life and designing my life so that I can take my sabbaticals, you know, overseas, wherever I need or want to, or I start to make my life so that I have this, I mean, I have this wonderful love and appreciation for Poland. It feels like a very inviting, it's a place that I feel more at home than not. And I'm looking forward to that next trip I can take. And in the meanwhile, what I'm working on is continuing to build our efficiency here, continuing to add, you know, quality staff so that I can have more people to create, to build what we do, who will have the same heart, have an intention and a love and a passion for building this harmony into our, you know, our products, our offerings to you guys. Are like, here is our creation for you. And it's something that is, you know, I'm looking at a set of Subaru shocks for a customer in Mexico, some Mazda 3 shocks. I've got some BMW PSS9s here for a local customer. There's E46 M3. There's a whole bunch of Miata stuff on the shelf. I've got some used Miata shocks. By the way, if you want a single or double adjustable, let me know. We have a set of singles and a set of doubles. We have some shafts for if people want some gun drilled, you know, basically we have some gun drill shafts for adjustables. But yeah, there's like a lot going on. The BMW is getting worked on right now. I haven't been driving it for about 3 weeks, and I'm looking forward to getting back into Christina and going autocrossing and to the track and all that good stuff. And sleep. I really started to appreciate the benefit of going to sleep by 10 o'clock. You know, like letting my body just wind down and turning off the TV, turning off the phone, turning it to airplane, putting it away, letting my body, as it gets dark, you know, we're meant to be asleep. Generally speaking, there are some people that are naturally night owls, often if those people end up being up, you'll maybe go to sleep or take a nap, and you wake up and you work a little bit and then go back to sleep. I mean, there's different types of sleep patterns. There's no one size fits all. But there is a lot to be said for having that restorative window, that 10 to 2, and certain hormones seem to need to be built and restored between like midnight and 4 a.m. So I would definitely recommend checking out Danger and Play. It's a really, really good site. Lots of useful information there, especially about health and real data. I mean, like, Mike Cernovich doesn't mess around. If he's called out a couple people, like Tim Ferriss and some others, saying that, you know, Tim Ferriss supposedly wrote the 4-hour body and 4-hour work week and 4-hour chef, and I've bought body and a work week, and basically said, show us your labs if you really have your testosterone at this level, all natural, blah, blah, blah. Show us your labs to prove it. And I don't think Tim actually did. So I definitely am, I'm an empirical scientist, and I want to know what I'm doing and how I'm benefiting, how I'm taking care of myself. Oh, and please, guys and gals, donate blood. Please, please, please go to your local blood banks and donate blood. I just got an email from Stanford yesterday. It said, you know, critical shortage of your type. And this is, you are one of few O negative donors, you know, that, you know, are available that we can call on. And I think my guess is that the areas that are more people, they need more donors, obviously, because more potential for accidents or diseases or people who need surgery and, you know, units of O or O neg for infusions. And I'm thinking about setting up some type of a benefit program, a thank you program for you guys. I don't want to go overboard. At the same time, I mean, if we get, because look, I like to reward people. I give you free shipping and handling. You get $75 off. You buy an elite setup, you donate blood, you get $75, you know, off of that. Being an O-neg myself, I know that I would love to know that there's like another 10, 20 O-neg donors in the Silicon Valley area. So in a way, if you are local, I'm probably going to set up something that's like a NorCal specific so that I can sort of, you know, if Stanford calls me, I'll say, you know what, call these other people because I'll go in when I can. And I do. And if I send them another 5 or 6 donors, then they ought to be much happier. I mean, the community is going to be happier and better off. And it's also good, especially for men, if your red blood cell counts, if you, I think your hematocrit and your red blood cell counts and your iron, I should say, your hemoglobin are on the higher end, then they usually recommend donating blood. And genetically, if you have, all of us have Neanderthal DNA, which has actually got a lot of interesting and beneficial adaptations. If you tend to run warm, Neanderthals generally lived in northern climates, colder, like northern Europe, etc. So they had to be cold adapted, and also they tended to get injured wrestling animals, fighting each other. But generally, you know, if you're trying to eat a woolly mammoth or something, and it's got tusks, and it's gonna either poke you or step on you, or you're gonna hit a rock or whatever, you're gonna bleed. And so we used to bleed a lot more, quite likely, getting our food than we do now. We just go down to the store, you know. So the idea of somebody having higher red blood cells, especially if you're Northern European, is probably more likely. I think, what is it, hyperferemia, and so, or those other conditions too. There was a guy I talked to a customer in New Zealand who mentioned that, and he said he suggested to donate blood. I said, well, you got a discount if you donate blood and send me evidence, and there's your incentive on the fat cat side. So this is a health benefit too. And also things like if you supplement like with liver pills, or you do aminos, especially liver pills, or if you eat more liver, like grass-fed liver. Somebody was saying that I came across something that was like the king lion is the only one in the pride that gets to eat the liver of any fresh kills. And so, you know, he basically said, so, you know, get your king lion on. Like, there's something that's going on with the nutrients and the nutrients in that liver, especially if it's grass-fed, so you know it's from really, really well taken care of animal, that is going to revitalize. It's going to vitalize you even more. So, and if you do eat the liver, then you're likely to, or if you eat red meat, which I like, I have like half of my protein from red meat, not quite half, but in that range. I supplement with whey and fish, salmon, you know, some chicken. You're probably going to elevate your red blood cells and your hemoglobin if you have the liver coming in too. So to donate blood brings you back to a level like every 2 months you can donate. And really, it feels really, really good when you do this. I mean, I think karma is a real thing. I've been ticket free. I just knocked on here. There's some wood. I've been without tickets for like 6 years or so, I think, 6+ years. I mean, and I drive reasonably, but I'll be passing people on the freeway. I'm not going 65 all the time. And just, you know, near misses and this and that, and, you know, let's do good things for the world too. It makes a difference. It feels good, and it's good for everybody. So encourage your friends, please donate blood. That's like really one of my pleas. And take care of yourself. You know, really do an honest assessment of where are you? Like, yes, I have another four videos that are all suspension, you know, related and modifications in this, and it's all good, fun stuff, and it's informative in that way. And you won't be able to enjoy yourself if you're not taking care of yourself. And I want all of you watching this to, wherever you are in the world, to balance your hobbies with just an honest self-assessment of where am I? Am I doing the best that I can so that my loved ones are going to enjoy me as the most vital adult I can be, whatever my age is? So thanks for being part of my tribe, my extended family. So you all take care of yourselves, and next time you see me, well, you'll see some older videos, but I'll be a little older and hopefully a little wiser, or at least less foolish. Nothing wrong with being foolish, so I'll just be me. All right, take care. Thanks. All right, to the other camera.